first met here, I said, and I was the first Green Seater to been to this location, and just what after Jennifer said, I don't want to let you all down, so I got to be out there. But really, I wanted to say welcome as well, because I've been able to travel here many times over the last several years, in this job, in other jobs, in other organizations, so it's been a great time. But being an Apache is absolutely my love for what I do. And I know for Mayor Johnson, or being able to run the Phoenix Marathon a couple times in your city solely, a hill thing called the Phoenix Marathon, you never would miss it. The first time I did, I did not get a run at this last weekend. I was signed up for it, but my son had his junior ROTC ball, and he's a senior, and there's no way I could skip that. So I had to stand up for his ball, because he had to escort his mother down the line with everybody in the sword and safety, so it was very good. But, from who we have here, from the congressman and congresswoman's office, and especially other dignitaries, you know, it's my pleasure to be here. I'm just talking a little bit about myself. I grew up in a very small town in Iowa, so the small feel of a company and being amongst people such as yourselves really, really weighs home to me. Kim and I get the opportunity, I try to do it every year, go back there. We've got some suppliers in Iowa too, so we do the same thing. But this is great to do it. And I never realized you were just across the other side of hockey field until General Crosby. I can't call him Ken yet. General Crosby approached me and said, hey, would you come over here and speak to GECO? And then when he said GECO, I knew from a little bit of my memory that we had parts, and there are a lot of parts on this aircraft, as you can imagine. And I was trying to recall what we did with GECO. He reminded me, and I said, absolutely, I would love to come and be a part of your day. And I hope they don't bore you too much, but I really, it really pleases me in this job when we get the opportunity, and especially for a supplier for Boeing, so we've got Kim with us as well, is to come out and tell you thank you. And that's probably how I'll really roll up when we get to the very end. And to kind of throw a little bit of where we're at in the program as well. Because I don't know if you see where we're at in the program. We used to, years ago, be able to go to our Quad A, the Army Aviation Association of America, give program manager updates. That's all gone now, because the budget cutbacks and everything, you don't get to do that. So a lot of individuals don't know where we're at in the program, how many aircraft we produce, where we're going for the future. And really, for a small company, this really applies to where we're going in the future and how long we're going to support this aircraft. And I know we just talked through a little bit of the history since 95, and I know what we're doing here with George and Jennifer and a lot of your history to be 20 years and celebrate 20 years. But, really in the early 2000s, I'd already been flying the aircraft for 7 years. I'm an Apache pilot, been flying Apache since 1988. Started out with the Alpha models, went to the Delta models. I'm not qualified in the Echo model, but I've flown the Echo model a few times. Realize what it can really do. So you got a lot of experience on it when you're actually flying what you're doing with this great airframe as it goes forward. But really what hits home and working with the units out in the field is what we do with the unmanned teaming capability, to what we do with the Ethernet router and all of that we have on the aircraft. Back when we had the Alpha model, we had no idea we could do anything like this. And in the early 2000s, when I was the Block 3 product manager, this is my third time back in Apache, I was there once as an APM, an assistant product manager, doing weapons and sensors, and then I came back as a product manager, which is the precursor. Block 3 was to the Echo model, and now back as the project manager. So my Army brother back then, Rob Johnson, had this program. He had the longbow. He was the product manager for that, and we started all of this man-to-man teaming and really trying to see if we can include this into the patch. And we have done it well. We've done it very well. With the way we've progressed since those days, since the MCAP days, and what we've done back with the capabilities insertions in 2000s to what we're doing, like we also spoke in 2011 to 2013, or 2012, we finished the EMD program on the Block 3, became the Echo model, and now we're actually producing those aircraft since 2011. So since 2011, we've got I think we just delivered 134, if I remember right. We're right around 133, I think I saw the message coming in, 134 Echo models. So right out in the field today, I've got 738 aircraft that I'm responsible for the USG. Now, we've got about another 600 for foreign military sales customers, but I'm really concerned with what we do with the United States government, because we still have people downrange in harm's way flying these aircraft every day, whether it's a Delta model or an Echo model. So as you all know, we had the Delta model, and we had the Mando 19-2, where I could receive the video feed and the metadata from any of the sensors that are flying around out in, you know, a manned aerial system or drone. You know, a lot of them kids have called the drones.